Let's take a look at how to deploy a Solid app to AWS Amplify. Now, of course, to deploy a Solid app, the first thing you need to do is to create a Solid app. And to do that, run npx digit solidjs slash templates slash js, and we can call the app Solid app. Now cd into the Solid app and run npm install to install the dependencies. Now, the reason I've done this is because the digit command is just like running a clone command, a git clone command. It doesn't automatically install the dependencies for you, so you have to do that manually. Now, once the installation is done, run npm run dev to start the app locally. We can click on the URL to take a look at the very, very simple app, which is enough to illustrate what's going to happen by the end of this video. Now close this window, and before we actually start deploying, let's run one more command, and that is npm run build. Now the reason why I've run this command is because you need to be aware of what happens when you run npm run build. And this is because Amplify is going to also run this command. And being aware of the fact that a dist folder is created is very important when we start configuring Amplify for our deployment. And the next step would be to actually push this project to GitHub. And the reason for this is we want Amplify to be able to pick up our commits and redeploy these changes that we've made. So create or initialize a repository, stage your changes, and commit those changes. And once you've done that, create a repository on GitHub, or we can call the repository Solid App. And once you've created the repository, what you can then do is add it as a remote URL to this project. And then finally, we can push this project to the repository you created. All right, so at this point, we have a Solid App, and we've also pushed that app to GitHub. And the last step is to actually take that repository from GitHub and give it to Amplify and have Amplify deploy that app to production for us. So the next step would be to head to the AWS console and search for AWS Amplify. When you find it, open it, click on the new app dropdown and click host web app. Then choose your Git provider. In this case, I'm using GitHub, but please feel free to use any of this Git provider if that's what you're using. Then click continue. Now on the next page, you're going to be required to provide or to select the repository we've just pushed to. Now before we do that, I need you to be aware that if this is your first time deploying with AWS Amplify, you have to give Amplify access to your Git provider, in this case GitHub. So Amplify can then be able to pull repositories and deploy from that repository. So let's select the repository. I'm not doing that because, of course, I already gave Amplify access to my GitHub account. So I can then go ahead and just select a repository and then leave the branch as main, then click next. And then I can click the edit button to edit this configuration file. Now, remember when I told you that we need to be aware of what happens behind the scene when we run npm run build? As you can see, Amplify knows that it needs to run npm run build, but what it doesn't know is what happens or what folder it needs to deploy to production after running that. Right now, it's guessing that it's the root directory, which of course is not true. So we need to change this from root to the dist folder, because now we are aware from running the npm run build at the beginning that the dist folder is where all of our assets go to. So change this to dist and then click the save button. And then finally click the next button and then click save and deploy if you're happy with the settings. Now Amplify is going to take a minute or two to deploy this app. I'm not going to have you awkwardly wait for me in silence while this app deploys. So what's going to happen is I'm going to jump out for a few seconds and jump back in once this deployment is done. All right, so as you can see, the deployment was successful. And if you go ahead and click the production URL, you can see that it opens up the same app we tested locally, but this time the only difference is that it's in a production URL and you can confirm that by clicking your address bar. And that's basically everything you need to know to be able to deploy a Solid app to AWS Amplify. Thank you so much for sticking to the end of this video. Catch you in the next one. Bye.